For drawing the cross-sectional diagram, at first you have to draw a box like this. Okay, the length and breadth of this box you have to assume as per the size of the page in which you are drawing. Then within the box, by following the textbook, you have to draw the contour lines like this. Okay, and here each contour lines have a specific value that you have to write by seeing your book. Okay, suppose this contour line having the value 100 meter, then here we have 200 meter, 300 meter and 400 meter. Okay, and on this side of the page you can write on the left hand side value of contours in meters. Okay, here you can like the write like this. Okay, but please maintain a good handwriting. Okay, I don't have space on this side, for that I cannot write. Okay, actually I'm recording with the help of tripod, for that my handwriting is not good, but you have to write over here value of contours in meter. Then what you have to do, you have to draw one cross section like this. Like here I have drawn the cross section line A and B. Okay, then here you have to assume one scale, 1 centimeter represents 100 meter. Okay, then after that, depending upon the scale, you have to make certain division on left hand side. Okay, each division will be of 1 centimeter. Okay, like here I have done, you see each division is of 1 centimeter. Okay, and the number of divisions here, it will depend upon the number of contour lines. Okay, now similarly on right hand side also you have to do the division, and please use a separate colored pen for doing such division. Okay, like here I am doing at first here, let me show you 1, 2, 3 and 4. So here also I have done 4 equal division, but I suggest you to use transparent scale, don't use this kind of wooden scale. Okay, I don't have transparent scale, for that I am using wooden scale, but I request the student, those who are the beginners, please use a proper transparent scale. Okay, now after drawing, means after doing division on both the side, you have to join the division. Okay, you have to join the divisions like this. You have to join the divisions with the help of the scale. Just simply join the divisions. You have to join the division like this, then you put the value, okay, of each division. Like this is the base level, here we have 0 meter on both side. Okay, then 100 meter, 200 meter, 300 meter and 400 meter. Similarly on this side also write the value 100, 200, 300 and 400. Okay, as you have written already over here value of contours in meter, so don't have to write over here mm and m or meter. Okay, then what you have to do, you have to draw perpendicular. Okay, you have to take these points where the cross section is intersecting the contour lines. You have to take these points like this. And from this point, you have to drop the perpendicular. Like I am dropping over here. Look. It should be properly perpendicular. And use broken line, okay, so that you can understand the thing very easily. Okay, since it is the line of 400 meter, so I'm dropping perpendicular from 400 meter till 400 meter, not 300 meter, okay, not 300 meter. I'm dropping from here the line till 400 meter. Then again, you have to drop another perpendicular line, okay, that is from the contour line 300 meter, like this. From here also you have to do the same. You have to drop the perpendicular line as per the value. Then from here also same process you have to follow, but please maintain the holding of scale. I mean to say, please hold the scale properly, okay, otherwise you will not get proper perpendicular line, okay. In my diagram the lines may not appear perpendicular because I have restrictions, okay, while doing the video. For that I am not able to show you the proper perpendicular lines. But if you use a proper scale, since I am not having a proper transparent scale, I am using the wooden scale, for that it appearing a bit means it is not perpendicular over here, these lines, but it is possible to draw perpendicular if you use proper wooden scale, okay. Then after this, if you use proper transparent scale, not wooden scale, I beg your pardon, after this you have to take this point, you have to mark this point. After marking, just simply join this point like this by means your free hand, okay, join this line, okay. Now look over here, you got a landform after joining this line. Like this. Let me make it more bold, okay, so that it become easier for all of you to understand. Okay. You are getting a cross section of this contour pattern. That means this cross section represents a particular landform, a particular slope, that is uniform slope. Then you just put shade over here, okay, you just put shade over here like this. You just put shade over here like this. And one more thing I want to suggest, that these particular lines when you are drawing, okay, these particular lines when you are drawing, okay, I mean to say every line what you are drawing in this particular diagram, except the box, the contour lines and the cross section, whatever line you are drawing, use pencil. Because if you erase this part, okay, if you erase this part, then it will look very nice, okay. And after erasing, if you put the shade like this, this part will look very nice. So my suggestion to all of you, that this cage you draw by using a black color pen. Since I don't have black color pen, I am using blue color pen. This particular cross section line you draw by using black color pen. Here I am using red color pen because I don't have again the black color pen, okay. In place of blue color, you draw the contour line by using brown color pen, okay. And write this value by using black colors. This 400, 300, 200, 100, write this value by using black colors. And after that, by using pencil, you do the remaining work, like drawing these perpendicular horizontal lines, drawing these perpendicular lines. All this thing you do by using your pencil, okay. After that, draw this particular thing, okay, by using brown color, okay. Then rub this part. Since it is drawn by pencil, you can rub this part. Then you put the brown color over here, it will look very nice, okay. So I hope I am able to make you understand how to draw the cross section diagram in this particular video. If you have any problem, please do share with me. your problem in the WhatsApp group. Thank you.